Phones have grown larger in size over the years. True to that trend, the largest phone in this year's Apple iPhone 12 lineup, the Apple iPhone 12 Pro Max, has also grown a little bigger. Instead of a 6.5-inch display that the 11 Pro Max had last year, this has a 6.7-inch display. The more real estate that you have to play with gives you a lot more immersive experience in terms of the apps that you're using, or if you're using it for video consumption or even for editing photos. The new design, the one with the flat sides and very, very thin bezel, something quite inspired by the iPad Pros, will perhaps not make you realize that this is a slightly bigger screen than before. 6.5 inches, now 6.7 inches. But for somebody like me who loves big screen phones, this big image change really does show up. I get a lot more space for typing, something that I'm very finicky about, and there's that little extra space when you're scrolling your Twitter feed, you're reading your emails, or when you're basically just editing a few photos as well. Now, speaking of the design, what I have here is the Pacific Blue color. This is the new variant this time around. There's no midnight green from last year. This is actually the highlight color for me from the iPhone 12 Pro series lineup. Apart from that, if we had to look at the front, it's pretty much like an iPad Pro. Very, very thin bezels around and the flat sides. You can actually make this phone stand up on a flat surface. In terms of the weight, this is slightly heavier than before, but you will not really feel it. I did not, particularly because I was used to the 11 Pro Max's weight. But apart from that, it's a really small trade-off for the kind of immersive experience, the big screen experience, and well, the big battery, which leads to a longer life, battery life on a single charge. All that really matters, and the weight really is a very small trade-off. So what really are the big changes compared to last year's big screen iPhone 11 Pro Max? The iPhone 12 Pro Max gets the newest and the latest and the greatest A14 Bionic chip. This is now the fastest smartphone processor that you can find in the smartphone ecosystem around the world right now. Well, this is significantly faster than the last year's chip, which itself was the fastest chip at that particular point of time. So performance really is not even in question. We really shouldn't be going in and saying, oh, this runs 6 apps at the same time, or you can run a dozen apps in the background at the same time. It really doesn't make any difference. Apart from that, the bigger size actually gave Apple the flexibility and the space inside the phone to put even larger pixels on this triple camera pro camera system. Now, what that means is the pixel sizes are bigger, the sensor sizes are bigger, you get a lot more light. In fact, for low light photos, the 12 Pro Max can take up to 87% more light. To be honest, the photos that I have clicked and the experience that I've had with nighttime photos and low light photos, Apple is not kidding. The kind of granular detail that you can figure out with these phones is something that really cannot be replicated with pretty much any other phone. Apart from that, computational photography has been the big thing for Apple this year. There are significant changes to Smart HDR as well as Deep Fusion. Deep Fusion now is a lot more active in a lot more scenarios and is able to pull out that little extra detail in every single photo that otherwise might have been lost in the processing. Apart from that, well, the highlight of the iPhone 12 Pro Max then has to be that it puts everything together that you would expect from a big screen phone without really feeling any complicated. The design, it just works. This design is something that I really love, particularly if you buy it in this color option. The flat side spines just allow me to hold the phone better, and all in all, everything just feels well in place. Even though there's a big camera module sitting here, the phone doesn't feel top heavy. It just sits very easily in the hand. So if you're typing like this, you won't feel the phone going down. All in all, the iPhone 12 Pro Max really is a serious upgrade compared to pretty much any iPhone that we've seen so far. With the fact that this has the triple camera setup at the back, the pro camera system, plus a few additional goodies that the camera gets compared to, let's say, even the iPhone 12 Pro, really sets the 12 Pro Max apart in the iPhone 12 series. This is something that Apple has done this year to differentiate the flagship phone from the rest of the lineup, something that wasn't very clear till last year. All in all, if you're looking for a top-notch iPhone, if you don't mind a big screen, the iPhone 12 Pro Max, really, there is no competition. This is, well, should be your default choice.